Well, you know, we understand that the families serve. It's not just the member of the military. It's actually the spouses and the children that serve as well. And I think it's important to listen to them, find out ways we can support them so that they can support the member of the military as well. And we had a great visit with about 20 spouses just now who were able to say, this is what's working and this is what we could use a little help with. I think so. You know, actually, this was more of a listening session. We wanted to hear from the spouses, what can we do in this position, what can we take back with us that we can maybe make your lives a little bit easier? What's one of the biggest frustrations that we could maybe solve or help to fix a little bit? So we got a lot of great ideas today that we want to take back. You know, if you have a military member who is confident, rested, secure, has the support from home, that person is going to do a better job, just like anybody else, if they have that support from home. But a spouse and children, they're sacrificing as well. And so to be able to come alongside them is important to us, because if we can do that and they're happy, then the military member is happy and everything works smoother. And there were several things that came up, one of them being a security clearance. So if they want to be a substitute teacher, it takes a year to get security clearance. That's a frustrating thing. Some of them have businesses, not being able to really practice those businesses here. Some of them are trying to get degrees from universities that are represented here on base, but certain credits don't transfer or scholarships run out. So specific things that I think really we could take back and we can kind of work on and say, can we all come together and figure out a better way to do this? Not that we know everything in the Office of the Second Lady, but we are in a position to get people in who do know what they're doing from the military. So we've made that commitment to the spouses in this room that we want to see if there's something. You know, for the next month or so, we're going to actually choose one thing that we can really focus on and kind of pile drive through to help these spouses. Well, that's right, I'm a Blue Star mom. So for all those moms out there, we're so proud of our service members. We're so proud of Michael and what he's doing. It's a calling. You know, he wasn't raised in a military family. He was raised in a family with great respect for military and just said, Mom, I want to be a Marine. And he loves being a Marine. But he also is newly married. So I know from having a daughter-in-law who is a military spouse, I'm starting to learn some of the struggles of that role, some of the difficulties, some of the joys and fun experiences that they're having, you know, starting their marriage in the military. But I think having it, you know, so close to home now, I think of Sarah when I go out and see all of these spouses. I think of the struggles that she has and how she wants to support Michael, but, you know, she needs her own identity as well. So we want to help in any way we can. I will tell you, art therapy is one of the most powerful mental health tools that is out there. And I have talked to military members all over the world. You know, you take these guys in the military, you guys are tough. You know, it's hard to say, I need help. I'm depressed. I go to a dark place. I have nightmares. I have TBI. I have PTSD. I need help. And it's hard to do that. It's really hard for someone who doesn't have any art background to even conceive of the idea that art could heal the brain. But we're actually doing a lot of research at Walter Reed. And we're actually taking pictures of the brain before therapy and after, whether it's music therapy, art therapy, drama therapy. And what happens is the brain waves actually change. They actually heal. I was at Schofield Barracks in Hawaii, spoke to a soldier there who said, I was suicidal. And we hear that a lot in our military. And he said, I really was at the end of my rope. And I started working with an art therapist. We worked with clay. And he said it was like miraculous. Working with the art therapist and working with the clay, he said, I don't go to that dark place anymore. Other soldiers have told us this has saved my life. I now, you know, I struggled with memory issues after TBI. We were in Alaska 2 days ago, and they were showing us one of the guys doing music therapy said, when I started working with the music therapist, all of a sudden I could remember where I left my keys. He said, I went into the session and my brain was scrambled. And after working through music therapy, he said, now my memory is returning and my life has more order and I don't have such anger issues. And, you know, so the arts therapy are so good for our military. And I'm seeing more and more that we need more and more arts therapy, whatever kind of art it is, on our bases, helping our soldiers, because the brain can heal. So if any of your fellow service members are here,